The Antonio Project present Gas Combustion Unit or GCU.
Hello everybody, good day and welcome back to my channel. After discussing about LNG cargo and its containment system in my previous videos, at this time we will discuss about cargo equipment. One of cargo equipment is gas combustion unit or called as GCU. This equipment used for cargo tank pressure management in several floating storage regasification unit or FSRU and LNG carrier. What is gas combustion unit? How is designed and how it's working? If you curious about that, let's check out my animation video. Oh yeah. Before we continue to watch my animation video about GCU, I would appreciate your support by subscribe to the channel. This is to give me additional gas to fire on my idea to create more video about marine education. Remember, sharing knowledge is the easiest way to do charity. Therefore, click subscribe, like, and share button. Let's start the engine and sailing to next discussion about GCU. Let's go.
What is gas combustion unit? For several floating storage regasification unit for FSRU and dual fuel diesel engine or DFD LNG carrier, gas combustion unit or GCU installed for burning excess BOG from cargo tank, which is not used by DFDE or other engine, in order to maintain tank pressure, ensuring the secure disposal of oil of gas or BOG that inevitably releases from LNG cargo, preventing releasing methane direct to the atmosphere. And for LNG carrier with steam turbine propulsion did not equipped with GCU, boil of gas or BOG, which is generated from cargo tank delivered to engine via vapor line through low duty compressor at compressor room. BOG or vapor can be delivered to GCU by free flow or pressurized using low duty compressor. Low duty compressor is electric motor driven located at motor room, separated from compressor room. Motor room is pressurized to avoid any methane entering motor room. Vapor then delivered to GCU after warm-up or pressurized at compressor room. Gas combustion unit or GCU located at the upside of the vessel above engine room, with the exhaust stack is attached inside of funnel area. How is gas combustion unit working process? Following is illustration video showing process of how is BOG generated on the cargo tank until it is burned at GCU. Due to natural convection, LNG boil off in temperature about -161 degrees Celsius at atmospheric temperatures. This boil off LNG called as boil off gas or BOG. Factors influence to the generation amount of BOG are as follows: heat ingress to the tank, chemical composition of LNG, movement of vessel, pressure of tank, type of tank, and level of the tank. When the heat ingress to the tank is high, for example due to the damage of insulation or outside temperature is high, the amount of BOG will increase. It is same also when the vessel tend to pitching or rolling in heavy weather. When tank level is reduced and reservoir of cargo tank is large, it is also will increase the amount of BOG generated. BOG is unavoidable and it is necessary to be removed, whether they consume as fuel for engine or reliquefied and return back to cargo tank. BOG form as vapor and pressurized above atmospheric pressure, about 0.07 bar to 0.2 bar for LNG carrier, and about 0.07 bar to 0.64 bar for FSRU. For details about natural convection, please watch my previous video on on the both link. Vapor flowing through vapor line and vapor heater. The temperature is between minus 150 degrees Celsius to minus 50 degrees Celsius on the vapor heater. Depend into tank level condition and LNG, cargo, and temperature. For free flow firing or bump start of GCU, it is not required low duty compressor running. Only by tank pressure is enough. But when dual fuel diesel engine running and necessary to fire on GCU to burn excess BUG, which is not used by VFDE, then it is necessary to run low duty compressor to increase pressure and gas flow. For this FSRU system, in order to run low duty compressor, it is requiring inlet gas temperature below minus 90 degrees Celsius. Therefore, spray pump necessary to be used to supply LNG to be mixed with BUG by spraying LNG at mixture in order to reduce vapor temperature to less than minus 90 degrees Celsius. The setting temperature is minus 120 degrees Celsius. Mixed vapor and sprayed LNG then entering mist separator to be separated between liquid and vapor. Liquid then return back to cargo tank via drain port. Meanwhile, vapor sucked by low duty compressor. Low duty compressor is two stage type. Suction inlet vapor temperature is about minus 120 degrees Celsius and pressure about 0.15 bar. By low duty compressor first stage, vapor pressure will be increased to about 2.5 bar with temperature about minus 45 degrees Celsius. Then, by second stage compressor, the pressure increased to about 6 bar with temperature about 34 degrees Celsius. Vapor from low duty compressor discharge line then cooled down at after cooler, and the temperature reduced from about 34 degrees Celsius to 33 degrees Celsius. After cooler cooling media is using fresh water. From after cooler, pressurized vapor distribute to a condenser, return to vapor heater, used as fuel in dual fuel diesel engine, and excess BUG to be burned at gas combustion unit. Gas combustion unit design and part name. GCU equipped with forceps, combustion and dilution fan. The airflow is constant, whatever the amount of burn gas is. The total airflow rate is calculated to obtain a maximum exhaust gas temperature below 535 degrees Celsius in the worst working condition, with temperature air is 45 degrees Celsius. Exhaust tank is outer wall of the GCU, where inspection manhole, flame scanner, peephole, temperature sensor, and combustion air pressure sensor are attached. Gas valve unit or GVU is the inlet control valve for GCU. The control valves are controlled by the GCU control cabinet. Air chamber is a chamber where four combustion and dilution fans are connected with discharge air ducting. combustion chamber. The combustion chamber stands inside the exhaust stack. Its four legs are screwed onto the deck. All parts are in stainless steel. Next is the instrument inside of combustion chamber. To see the instrument, it is necessary to fire off GCU. To fire off GCU, it can be stopped from local control panel or on the IS monitor or by remote. By pushing stop button, GCU will automatically fire off. Its sequence are as follow. Push stop button. Slowly cash flow reduced to minimum 450 kg per hour. Then, gas inlet valve will close. GCU control valve reduced to minimum. Flame fire off. And to purge valve open. GCU control valve opening to full. And to purge start. And to purge complete. And to purge valve close. GCU control valve close. If the fans are running and GCU is in stop mode, the fans will be automatically stopped after 30 minutes. The GCU can be operated in two modes, normal gas mode and train warming mode. Normal gas mode, this mode is the nominal mode. The amount of nitrogen or inert gas is to be between 0 and 50% in mass. Tank warming mode. This mode occurs during the phase of tank filling or tank purging with N2 or inert gas. In this mode, the ignition transformers will be kept in operation to provide a constant ignition source, and flame detection will be bypassed. Therefore, at any loss of flame will not lead to GCU shutdown. Two intermittent electric spark igniters are also fixed on the baffle next to the burner. One is sufficient to ignite the burner. Its igniter is powered by an electrical transformer. Burner. This burner belongs to induct burner family, meaning it does not require an air gas ratio control device. The correct amount of oxygen required for the combustion is taken from the air introduced in the combustion chamber around the burner and through the baffle. UV flame scanner. Its system is composed of a UV cell and a flame relay. The UV cell is fixed on a support on the combustion chamber so as to detect the flame in all possible working conditions. It should always be supplied with instrument air, including when GCU is stopped, for cooling down and to avoid dust. The flame relays are implemented in the control cabinet. For fire on GCU, the sequence are as follow. Push start button. GCU fan will start one by one, and the GCU fan will start. Three parts of combustion chamber. Gas control valve slightly open and first piping line. Two igniters going. Gas valve open, flame on. Gas control valve adjusting to the required gas flow. Depending on the types, for this type of GCU, the minimum gas flow is 450 kg per hour and maximum gas flow is 4500 kg per hour.
That's all, small discussion about gas combustion unit or GCU. I do hope that this video will give you additional information about LNG cargo equipment. I will create more video about LNG in future. So don't forget to click subscribe and click bell button so you will not miss my new video. Anyway, thank you for watching my video and see you in my another video. Bye bye.
If you have any question or suggestion, please leave your comment down below. Again, don't forget to click like and subscribe button and share knowledge for others.
Thank you for watching my video. Terima kasih, The Antonio Project.